332.
You good? You good? Well, good evening. Welcome to Victory Baptist Church tonight. Let's all get a songbook, stand and turn to page 332. Page 332.
House on this Wednesday night. Certainly good to see y'all here this evening. And let's do pray tonight for the service. And let's do continue to remember all the families in our church that are going through sickness and trials, different situations. Pray for them tonight that the Lord will touch them and help them. Amen. And as we pray, let's continue to pray for Brother Mike and also member Holly as well, all of her family. Pray for Mike. God will continue to help him, strengthen him, and then pray for comfort for Holly's family there where her sister passed away last week. So just pray much for them, and then continue to pray for Brother Combs. They are treating him with medications instead of doing anything about one of the stents. And so just pray that God will touch him, amen, and the Lord will meet that need there. Continue to pray for Brother James and Beulah, remember them tonight, and just pray the Lord to meet the need there. Also, remember Janice Phelps, as she's still recovering from having surgery. And then, if you will, continue to pray for Brother Jim Jones. Pray for him and his wife, family, Lord to meet the need. Amen there. And pray for all the others that are sick in our church, that God will touch them most of all. Let's pray for those tonight that are lost in our families. Family Day coming up in a week from Sunday. Pray that we can get some of our family in, and pray that God will deal with their heart, and it would be a blessing to see some of them saved, amen, on Family Day. So really pray and invite your family, friends, co-workers, neighbors, everybody you can get to come, get them all to come, and let's fill the house of God up. Looking forward to the Rogers family being here and singing, and so let's just pray much about that service coming up. Amen. All right. Well, let's take some prayer requests tonight before we pray. Any others tonight? All right. Amen. Pray for Brother Dale. Amen. All right. Well, that's all can we. Let's gather around the altar tonight to pray. And remember all of our missionaries. Pray for them tonight. Wherever they may be around the world, here at home, and all that's going on in their ministries, pray that God will give them many souls for their labor as they carry the gospel. Amen. And pray for our young people as they're meeting tonight also. And pray that God will keep his hand on them, and pray for our school, all the staff and their families, all of our students and their families. Pray for them, amen, and just pray the Lord's will be done in all of our lives, amen. All right, any others just before we pray tonight? Well, let's just all pray together. Lord, we're glad, Lord, to be able to be here tonight. God, we thank you for health and strength. And God, thank you for what you've done in our lives. And Father, tonight as we come, we pray that you bless all these requests that have been made known. Lord, we pray for every need tonight. I pray for Brother Mike Hazelton. God, that you'd touch him. Father, I pray strength and
strength in him. Lord God, may you bless him and help him, Father. God, just restore his health, my Father. I pray, Lord, for Holly and God, all of her family, and that you comfort them, and God, give them comfort, grace, and peace, Lord. I know that you, like only you can, Father, I pray you just meet every need. I pray, Lord, tonight that you continue to touch all the sick in our church, Father. As we bless Brother James, and you, the Lord, touch them. Pray for Brother Dale as he goes back tomorrow to the doctor, God, that he'll get good news. I pray you touch him, Father. We pray for Janice Phelps tonight. Lord, you touch her. Bless her, my Father. God, just meet the need there. We pray for Brother Combs, asking the Lord to touch him, help him, Father. Thank you for what you have done for him. And tonight, Lord, again, all these requests, God, that have been made known. We pray, God, for Spring, God, that you touch her. Pray for the girls and Tim. And we pray for Rita, Lord. I pray that you touch her. God, everything will be well. And Father, we're just so thankful and grateful that we can call upon your name, God, in the times of need. And, oh, Father, we bring all these needs, Lord, every name in the bulletin tonight. God, we pray for each one, Father. God, you know the need. But, Lord, most of all, we pray for those in our families that are lost. God, we want to see our families saved. Father, we want to see the church families saved. And we pray, Father, that the Spirit of the Lord will bring conviction. And, Lord, that you would draw them, my Father, to the Lord Jesus. And, oh, that they'll be saved before it's everlasting too late. God, we pray, God, that you bless our missionaries. Help them, Father, around the world. Thank you, God, for their faithfulness, dear God. Thank you, God, for supplying their needs. And pray that you keep them safe and well. And God, use them in a great way. Father, we pray for our young people tonight as they meet. And God, you bless and help them as they study the Word. And God, as they sing the songs of Zion. And God, as they fellowship one with another, God, may you bless them and strengthen them, and God, use them in a great way. Thank you for what you're doing in their lives. And Father, tonight we pray that you bless our school. Oh, God, all of our staff and their families, Father, God, please meet every need. And Lord, all of the students and their families, God, we ask you to help them. Lord, especially those that are lost, we want to see them saved. Lord, we need your touch here, we pray. Lord, for revival, we pray the revival continue to move forth. And, oh, God, that you'd stir our hearts. Lord, stir here in our county, our city, my Father, our churches. And bless all the men of God as they preach tonight. Oh, my Father, we need your touch this evening. We need your help, Lord. God, we need you more than we need anything or anybody. And I pray that you'd help us tonight. God, meet with us, stir our hearts, dear God. Thank you again for everyone here tonight in the building. Oh, God, just meet with us. Help us, Lord. Lord, we do pray for Family Day coming up.
Oh, in just a week and a half, oh, God, that you'd meet with us then. And God, that you'd save precious souls. And bless, Lord, every need that comes through the door. Oh, Father, thank you now, God, for what you've done. Thank you for what you're doing. And, Lord, we thank you in advance, God, for what you're going to do. We ask it all in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
All right, let's get a book and stay standing and turn to page 354. Page 354.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. It sure is good to be in the Lord's house. Amen. Good to see all of you tonight. Hope you've all had a good week so far. And if you haven't, I hope it gets better. If you have, I hope it keeps being that way. And if it gets bad, we just have to take it anyway. Amen. Amen. But we're thankful for the goodness of the Lord. Amen. If you have your Bible tonight, turn with us to the book of Psalms, Psalm 20 this evening. Psalm 20 tonight. And while you're turning there, of course, we've done mentioned the Family Day coming up. A week from Sunday, March the 5th, Family Day with the Rogers family. And then, of course, we'll have a meal after the morning service. And so we just need all the ladies to fix up some good treats, sweets, and, you know, maybe a few vegetables thrown in there. Amen. But looking forward to a great day. Hope you'll invite and work and pray. Work on your family. Try to get them to come with you. And friends, anybody you can, get them to come. and be here for Family Day on the 5th of March. And then Friday night, this coming Friday night, is the final ball game of our season, and it's our annual blue-white game and homecoming night, and it starts at 6 o'clock with the girls' game. And so we encourage, if you can't come, be here Friday night. And I know it's a night where sometimes some of the alumni that have graduated from our school that played ball comes back and plays against the present team. And then we have some of the parents that play. And so it'll be a good, be a fun night. It'll be funny, amen, I'm sure, at times. Yeah, I said homecoming. Yeah, I said it. Yeah, I said that. Amen. And then, of course, Saturday, we're planning on trying to work on putting some of the playground equipment together Saturday morning at 9 o'clock. And then I see that they're calling for like a 70% chance of showers, rain Saturday. So I don't know exactly how that's going to turn out. And so we'll just have to kind of watch the weather. If you can come over and help us a little while, try to get some of this playground equipment together that's been bought and people donated and gave and helped us get it. And so we got several things we need to get put together. I told them we'd try to get some of the smaller stuff put together and then work on the bigger stuff later. But we can get a start on it anyway, amen? And that'll start at 9 o'clock Saturday morning if you can. Come on over and be with us. All right, tonight in the book of Psalms, Psalm number 20. In Psalm 20, the Bible says, "The Lord hear thee in the day of trouble. The name of the God of Jacob defend thee. Send thee help from the sanctuary and strengthen thee out of Zion. Remember all thy offerings and accept thy burnt sacrifice, Selah. Grant thee according to thine own heart and fulfill all thy counsel. We will rejoice in thy salvation, and in the name of our God we will set up our banners. The Lord fulfill all thy petitions. Now know that I, the Lord, saveth his anointed. He will hear him from his holy heaven with the saving strength of his right hand. Some trust in chariots and some in horses, but we will remember the name of the Lord our God. They are brought down and fallen, but we are risen and stand upright. Save, Lord, let the King hear us when we call." Our Heavenly Father, tonight again we thank you for the privilege to be here in your house. And again, Lord, thank you for everyone here in the building, for all the young people that are here tonight. We ask you, Lord, just for a little while that you might help us as we study your word. God, give us wisdom, understanding, and anointing, God, from heaven to be able to preach the word. God, may our hearts be open and receptive, Father, to that which you have for us tonight. Lord, I again want to say thank you for your goodness, your mercy, your grace. Thank you, Lord, for every blessing you've given, Lord, this day alone. And Father, for all you've done in our lives, and Lord, allowing us again to gather together, Lord, to pray together and worship together, and Lord, fellowship one with another. I pray, God, that we'll be strengthened, Lord, tonight through the word of God, and Lord, everything that's done, we'll thank you, we'll praise you, for we ask all this in Jesus' name, amen. I want to preach tonight from this psalm, and I want to preach on the thought, God gives the victory. Now, in the 20th Psalm, David pens a prayer for Israel to pray while he is in battle. And David placed his trust in God for protection in the day of trouble because he knew that God would give him the victory. And David knew this from his own experience. God had delivered him from the lion and from the bear. As he tended the sheep, God had delivered him from Goliath, and God would deliver him in this battle as well. And you and I tonight, we can depend on the Lord. to give us victory, amen, and give us what we need in the days of our battles. God, help us tonight to trust him in the day of our trouble, because it is him that will give us the victory. And it's evident throughout the history of David that David, he fought and won many battles in his life. And the reason for his victories was because David sought after the Lord. Throughout the book of Psalms, the Psalms are filled with prayers that were written by David for support and for deliverance. And David knew how to react. And David knew exactly where to run. He knew who to cry to during the days of his trouble. Every one of us in this building tonight, we have seen our share of pain and heartache and days of trouble, amen? And once again, we're reminded that it's how we're going to react when we face these difficult times in our lives. Amen. And we are going to face them. If you've got over them, thank God for it. But I'm afraid I'm going to have to tell you, there may be some more battles down the road. And it's how we react to all that comes in our lives that makes the difference. Some people, when they have problems or they are going through battles, the first thing they want to think about is just quitting, giving up. Well, that's the worst thing you could do. And that's what the devil wants you to do, amen, is to give up and to quit. There are many who want to just give up. Then there are many who want to blame God, or they blame somebody else for what they're going through. And many want to try something other than God. Well, I think if I can do this or that. No, what we need to do is stay with the Lord. Stay with God, amen. It is God that will give us the victory. And in these verses, the Bible identifies how that we are to react in the day of our trouble. And I'm glad tonight we can see that God gives the victory. Notice, first of all, in verses 1 through 4, we can rely on God's protection. Amen. We can rely on God's protection. I'm glad tonight I know who my protector is. I'm glad that he is our protector, amen? We can rely on him. That's where our dependence, our confidence should be in him, amen? Because he is our protector. I know a lot of people, they have guns in their home, and there's nothing wrong with it, but I'm glad God is my number one protector, amen? Somebody said, I don't believe you ought to have a weapon. Well, tell David that when he went and fought Goliath. Amen. I mean, we know God was the one that gave him the victory. Say amen. And it was God that done what had to have done when David slung that stone. David didn't have the power to sling a rock that hard to make it sink in the forehead of a giant and make him fall forward on his face. It was God, amen, that gave the power to be able to do those things. And you and I tonight, we have things at our disposal, but I'm not dependent on those things. I'm dependent on the Lord, amen, to help us and to protect us. Praise God. And so, but there's a lot of people that they are depending on so many other things or so many other people, and our reliance, our dependence should be on the Lord. Amen. He is our protector. Now, David in this psalm, he gives a simple prayer that all of us can pray. First of all, he asked God to defend him. He asked the Lord to defend him. Hey, we can ask God to defend us. Amen. The Bible said in verse 1, the Lord hear thee in the day of trouble. The name of the God of Jacob defend thee. The word defend that David uses is a word that actually means to make lofty, or is like the word inaccessible. In other words, the enemy is active and he wants to destroy the plan that God has for your life. Jesus made it clear in John 10:10 when he said, the thief cometh not but for to steal, to kill, and to destroy. That's all he desires to do. He's never wanted to help anybody out. He's never wanted to see anybody get better. He's always wanting to destroy, to kill, and do all those things to people. But when our day of trouble comes, The devil will attack your thought life. That's where it all begins. When problems begin to arise, our mind begins to spin, and the devil tries to put thoughts in our mind to try to draw us away from our dependence upon the God of heaven, amen? And instead of thinking crazy thoughts and getting our mind too far from God, we need to go to the word of the Lord and ask God to help us, amen, in those days. I'll tell you, our thoughts, if we're not careful, our thoughts will arise against God and against the plan of God. Amen? And it's that in that time that you need to draw your attention to the Lord and ask God to make the enemy inaccessible, amen, to set the devil at a place where he cannot attack you. And David often asked God to keep him in the shadow of his wings. He wanted God to hide him and to keep him inaccessible from the devil. Amen. Oh, listen, we can ask God to defend us. Not only that, but he said you can ask God to help you. Look at verse 2. Send thee help from the sanctuary and strengthen thee out of Zion. Amen. The sanctuary in Zion are references to the tabernacle, to the temple. And again, representing the presence of God. In Exodus chapter 33, verses 14 and 15, he said, and he said, my presence shall go with thee, and I will give thee rest. And he said unto him, if thy presence go not with me, carry us not up hence. In other words, Moses said, God, if you're not going to be with us, don't let us go. Lord, we need you. And tonight, you and I, we need God. Amen. We need him now more than ever before. Hallelujah. And we need to do that in our lives. Just realize we need the Lord. And we just can get help from the Lord. Amen. Ask God to help you. Ask God to be that which you need to be in your life. Amen. And I'm thankful tonight God will do that. I'm telling you, you can't live without help. And we cannot live without the help of God in our lives. Amen. You can't live the Christian life without the help of God. We can't be what we need to be without the help of God. And so I'm glad we can ask God to help us, to defend us. But then the psalmist, he said in verse 3, ask God to remember you. Look at verse 3. Remember all thy offerings and accept thy burnt sacrifice, Selah. You ever forgot something? I'm probably talking to a crowd tonight that never forgets anything. But have you ever forgot something because you didn't write it down? That's bad, ain't it? There's been a lot of times I'll be going down the road and God will give me a thought. And I thought, well, I'm going to write that down when I get home. I ain't never had it again. And so if I got Debbie in the car, I say, hey, write this down. Because it's hard for me to write and drive, see, man. But you ever forget something because you failed to write it down? Amen. And somebody said the shortest pencil is still the longest memory. Some thoughts are just like the wind, fleeting. Amen, they're gone. So if you don't have some way to capture those thoughts when they come, we won't ever get anything accomplished. Amen. I know my wife, I thank God for her. She writes everything down. If she didn't, I would be lost. I would not know what to do because she wouldn't be there to have it wrote down for what I need to do. Amen. But listen, even though sometimes we're prone to forget, and I have found out, Brother Chris, since I have entered my 60s, that I am more prone now to forget things than ever before. Amen. I remember a few years ago it was bad. I went to my doctor one time before he passed away, and I said, Doc, I think I'm getting dementia or something. He said, what do you mean you think you're getting dementia? What's wrong? I said, look, I said, I'm be at church. I said, I can stand at the front door of the church. Somebody will tell me something that I need to do or a prayer request or a name, and I said, before I can get from the door to the pulpit, it's gone. He pulled out a notepad. He said, this is what you've got to do. I thought, yeah, I ain't doing that. And that's the reason I keep forgetting stuff. Amen. But sometimes we're busy and we've got so many things going on, it's hard to keep up with everything. Amen. But aren't you glad God will remember you? Amen. Oh, even though you're busy and you forget a few things, God will never forget you. Praise God. I saw a picture today of a little sparrow, and it says, his eyes on the sparrow and his eyes on me. Well, I'm glad God will never forget us. Amen. Oh, listen, Jesus made the promise, I am with you always, even to the end of the world. I'm glad God loves each and every one of us in this building tonight. And God cares about all of your needs individually. And isn't it wonderful that God knows everything about me? He knows all that I need, and he can do anything that needs to be done. But he does the same thing for each of us individually tonight. Praise God. I'm glad we serve a great God. I'm glad we serve a mighty God that will never forget us. He always knows what we need. He always knows where we are. Amen. And he told us again in Hebrews 13:5, he said, for he has said, I will never leave thee nor forsake thee. Amen. I'm glad tonight we have a God that cares about us. And not only David said you can ask God to defend you, ask God to remember you, ask God to help you. But he said you can ask God to answer you. Look at verse 4. He said, grant thee according to thine own heart and fulfill all thy counsel. You know, America today, there is so much technology that it is almost impossible not to communicate with someone somehow. Amen. And to me, it don't seem like it's been that long ago where you just have to wait till you got home to make a phone call. And the phone was hanging on the wall or sitting on the desk. And it had a cord on the end of it. Amen. But now you can get in touch with just about anybody, anytime, everywhere. Amen. I mean, isn't it amazing? But yet at that could fail at any moment. We could be in a need, and we could be in an emergency, and one of those things could fail us. Our phone battery could be dead, or we could be out of a service area, or anything could happen. They not have their phone on. But aren't you glad tonight there's a God in heaven that's never, never, praise God, afar from your cries, and he can always hear, amen, no matter what's going on in our lives. Oh, in the middle of the night, when nobody knows your heart but the Lord, when nobody else is around, I'm glad you can commune with God from the depths of your soul, and I'm glad he will hear and he will answer you. Amen. Oh, listen, you could be anywhere, praise God. And this simple prayer by David can be adapted in our prayer life in order to have the protection in the day of trouble. Praise God. We're living in desperate times and despairing times, and we're living in these evil days. But hey, I'm glad we've got the protection of an almighty God, amen, at our disposal. Tonight, he tells us that we can rely on God's protection. But then not only that, but notice secondly, he said we can rest in God's provision. In the day of trouble, we must continue to trust God. Boy, it's easy to trust God when everything's going good. When you're healthy, your family's well healthy, and you got a little wealth, and your bills are paid, and your cars are running, and the washing machine's running, the dryer's running, the hot water heater's not leaking, and I mean, everything's just wonderful. But then something can happen. Amen. But I'm glad we still have God, and we must trust God no matter what. And the concept of trusting God is what gave Israel problems throughout their history. After Israel crossed the Red Sea, they couldn't trust God to give them food. They could not trust God for water. It was difficult for them to trust God when times were not going their way. I mean, things got so bad, they said, we just wish you'd left us in Egypt. Well, a few weeks ago, that wasn't the tune they were singing. They were praying, God, get us out of here. Amen. Now they've got a few heartaches and a few problems, and they're saying, you just should have just left us to die there. But they began to, it was hard for them to trust God. And there's a lot of people the same way today. It's hard for them to trust God. I mean, they just can't see how God is going to take care of them. But you and I tonight, most of us in this building tonight, most of us got a little age on us. Say amen right there. Some of you, we got some young ones. But we've got a few older heads in here. And but all we need to do when we see trouble is, hey, let's look back. I think probably a few of y'all have probably had some trouble in the past. How many of you had some problems? Well, did God bring you through that? Did God deliver you through it? Did God meet every need? Oh, it was difficult. It was difficult. We had some dark days and some sad times and some hard times. But hey, we see that through it all, God delivered us. God took care of us. Well, why can't we just keep trusting God now? Amen? Let's just keep trusting the Lord. But a lot of people have a problem by just trusting God, that God is going to meet everything in their lives. Amen? And people begin to trust in other things. That's why David said some trust in chariots and some in horses. In other words, they were trusting in those things that they thought were strong and were able to do something for them. And there's a lot of people the same way today. They'd rather trust something they can see, amen, than to trust God. Oh, listen, we see some hard times in our day right now. And people are turning to the wrong things for their provisions, amen. Some trust in chariots, some in horses. I've heard people say, boy, if I could win the lottery. I'm always picking it, Debbie. We'll ride down the road and I say, look at there, $452 million. Look at there. I said, if you win the lottery, I'm going to buy me a BMW. And she'll start singing, I'd rather have Jesus. I'm like, shut up. Amen. Get spiritual on me, will you? Amen. But I mean, people think, man, if we could just come into a fortune. Can I say tonight, it probably would ruin all of us. None of us would probably be worth a hoot by then. But that's people, they think, if we can do this, if we can do that, if I can just do this, if I can go here, if I can go there, if I can, it's not those things, it's the Lord. He's the one that we've got to rely on. He's the one that is able to take care of us, amen. Oh, if I could just do this. Some trust in chariots, some in horses. You know, we hear it all the time that people, they're trying to, of course, they don't like anything about God on anything. And, of course, there was a time that they were talking about wanting to take In God We Trust off our money. They just won't get rid of God. But I'm going to tell you something. Our nation would be in a mess if it wasn't for God. Amen? Our nation would be in a mess if it wasn't for the Lord. And so I'm glad that they have not been successful because I still trust in God. I'm not trusting in the dollar, but I'm trusting in the God of heaven. Amen? To take care of every need that we have. Praise God. Listen, do we really trust Him? That's the question. We can say, yes, I trust the Lord. But when it comes down to it, do we really trust Him? Do we really trust Him to meet every need? Amen? Some trust in chariots, some in horses. But those who really don't, they don't care anything about that. They don't want to hear about faith. They don't want to hear about just believe God, just trust the Lord. Oh, but that's all we can do tonight. Amen. We remember the name of the Lord is what David said. Why didn't David trust in chariots and horses? You and I, should we trust in material possessions or things other than God? I'd say no, we should not. And David answers these questions in verse 5 and 6. He said, "We will rejoice in thy salvation, and in the name of our God we will set up our banners. The Lord fulfill all thy petitions." Christians should trust God because salvation comes from him. And salvation in this context doesn't mean talking about your soul being saved, but it's a context of being delivered, amen, from your needs. David knew that God would deliver him from the hand of the enemy. The Bible informs us that there were many times that David was surrounded by the enemy. Many times he was surrounded. Many times he was in a difficult place. But I'm glad he wasn't trusting in a horse. He wasn't trusting in a chariot. He was trusting in the God of heaven. And the God of heaven delivered him, amen, each and every time. Tonight we can find faith and hope in the story of David. And David and Goliath and David and King Saul and his own son and others, they demonstrate how David was surrounded by the enemy. I mean, there was the Goliath and a whole Philistine army, and there was Saul trying to kill him. His own son was wanting to kill him. Others had tried to take his life, but oh, thank God, God took care of him. God defended him. God delivered him. Amen. And God will do the same for you and I. And I try to encourage your heart as well as mine tonight that if you've got troubles, and you probably do, and problems that sometimes may seem overwhelming, but I want to encourage all of us tonight by saying, trust God. Amen. Trust God. Oh, I tell you what blesses me when I talk to other Christians that have been through some difficulties in their lives. And hear them talk about and give testimony of how God met every need, how God took care of them, amen? How God protected them and what God has done in their lives. And I'm thinking, if God can do that for them, he can do it for me, amen? And when we read the stories in the Bible, they're not just stories, they are pictures of deliverance from God. And that's where we see tonight, we just need to trust the Lord, amen? Oh, listen, we can trust God because he hears and he answers our prayers. Verse 6 says, "Now know I that the Lord saveth his anointed. He will hear from his holy heaven with the saving strength of his right hand." Hey, I'm telling you tonight, when you begin to cry to the Lord, his ear is not heavy than he cannot hear. Hallelujah. God is listening, amen, to the cries of his children. There are many other verses in the Bible that is testifies to this very fact, amen. Isaiah 59:1 says, "Behold, the Lord's hand is not shortened that it cannot save, neither is ear heavy that it cannot hear," amen. I'm glad God can hear us when we pray. God gives the victory. And in order for us to have the victory, we must rely on God's protection. We must rest in God's provision. And then thirdly, we must remember God's promise. Look at verse 8. He says, "They are brought down and fallen, but we are risen and stand upright. Save, Lord, let the king hear us when we call." They're brought down. The enemy, they're brought down. And we stand. Amen. We're standing. In the day of trouble, Christians must remember God's promise of victory. Amen. I don't like to lose, do y'all? We played ball last night, both our teams lost. I hated it. I can't stand it. I wanted us to mop the floor up with them. Amen. But nevertheless, we did not win. Amen. I don't like losing. But it happens. And to be honest, I don't know of anybody that really likes to lose. All right, boys, let's play to lose tonight. No, we're always setting out setting our goals high. We want to be winners. Amen. We want to win at those things. But hey, but I'm telling you tonight, we don't always win. Amen. And I'm sure that these professional athletes, if they'd talk about they'll be playing a game, I'm going to go in there and do the worst I can so we can lose. No, that's not what they're playing. They're playing to win. Hey, as a Christian, I don't want to just be a Christian and wind up being a loser at the end. I want to win. I want to serve God. I want to be victorious. Amen. Praise God. I want to go out of here serving the Lord, doing what I can for God. I don't want to go out of here falling to the wayside. I want to be going for God. Amen. And so we can stand, and we can stand on the Word of God. We can stand on the promises of God. And the promises of God will help us to be able to stand in these days. Amen. It's comforting to know that we have the promises of God. To know even though trouble is all around us, we still stand. I know several years ago, this lady got mad at me in the school. And I could probably write a book on it. Everybody's been mad at me. But boy, she got heated mad. I mean, man, she was like a fire-breathing dragon. Oh, man. She said, I'll close you down. I said, hallelujah. Help yourself. At that time, I didn't really want to be here myself. Amen. Going through all that rigmarole. But see, hey, we ain't been closed down. There's probably been a lot of people say, I don't see how y'all keep going. I do. We got the Lord. Amen. If it hadn't been for God, we couldn't keep moving. Amen. Couldn't keep going. But we can stand. We can stand in the day of trouble. We can stand when things are going wrong. We can stand when it seems like our world is coming down around us. Why? We stand on the promises of God. Amen. That's where we stand. I close with this. I'm sure you've heard the story of Horatio Spafford. They said he was a great Christian man that knew a lot about sorrow in his life. He lost his only son at 4 years old to pneumonia. They said that he lost part of his life savings during the Great Chicago Fire. And when he started to get his life turned around, someone told him to go to England to hear a preacher preach in a revival there. And so he got tickets to take a ship there with his family. But at the last second, someone told him that he needed to stay an extra day and clean up what the fires had destroyed. So he stayed behind and he sent his family on ahead. On the way to England, the ship that he was on or his family was on collided with another ship and he lost all three of his daughters. But he found comfort with the Lord. On his way to England, his wife survived, his three daughters did not. And on his way to England to be with his wife, he told the captain, he said, Captain, I want you to let me know when we get to the place where my daughters died. After that, he saw the place, he went to his room and he wrote these words, when peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever my lot, thou hast taught me to say, it is well with my soul. Though Satan should buffet, though trials should come, let this blessed assurance control that Christ hath regarded my helpless estate and has shed his own blood for my soul. Can you imagine the sorrow that dad had in his heart? But yet he knew where his hope and his trust was in the Lord and in this relationship with him through the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen? Oh, listen, I don't know what life will hold in the days to come. I mean, we're a lot of times in the last month, we have been shocked by certain events that have happened in people's lives. I mean, just out of nowhere, something happens. And the whole things change. Your family and my family, it could change in one moment of time. It won't take much. But our trust tonight is in the Lord. Amen. All I can say is I know that it is well with my soul. Amen. And tonight when you're going through trials and troubles, sorrows and heartaches, battles and discouragement, all that you go through, you can rest assured there is a God in heaven that's there for you. Amen. And he will defend you. He will hear you. He will help you. He will provide for you. He will give you what you need. But we've got to just trust him. His timing and my timing don't always work. Brother Rick, he don't always work by my clock. But he always works on his clock. Kind of like that song Karen Peck sings when it seems like he's 4 days late, but he's always on time. We may think, Lord, where are you? Hey, he's coming. Just hold on. His time is not our time, and his ways are not our ways. That's why we just got to trust him. Don't trust in chariots and horses and other things that this world has. Trust in him. Father, tonight, thank you again for your word. Lord, thank you for the encouragement that it gives my heart. Oh, God, thank you in those days of darkness and difficulty. I'm glad there's a God in heaven who knows where we are, knows what we need, can hear the cries of our heart. Lord, even at times when we don't know how to put the words together, but I'm glad that you understand the very groanings of our heart. Oh, Father, may you bless your people tonight. God, may you meet every need in their lives. And God, help us tonight to trust you, for there is victory in the Lord. And we'll thank you, Father, for all that's done, for I ask it all in Jesus' name. While we stand tonight and our heads are bowed, well, I just try to encourage you this evening, just trust God. In the good times, trust the Lord. In the dark days, just keep your eyes on Jesus. When you're discouraged, oh, how we need to cry to him in our hearts. He is the one that is able. Some trust in chariots, some in horses, but we trust in the living God. Father, again, bless your people. God, bless the remainder of the week, and God, keep your hand on your people. God, help us that we might be a light and a witness to Christ, for Christ. Lord, bless the family day coming up a week from Sunday. Help us, Lord, that we can get some of our family and friends to come and be with us for family day. Oh, we'd love to see the church filled. And Lord, most of all, we'd love to see some heart filled with the saving grace of God. Oh, Father, please, have your will, have your way. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Sure appreciate you being here tonight in the service. Hope you have a good rest of your week. Pray much for the services coming up Sunday. And come and be with us. Bring somebody with you this Sunday. Amen. And also, I'll mention it Sunday again, but Calvary Baptist Church, they're going to have winter revival starting next week. And Brother Alan Johnson from Knoxville, Tennessee, will be over there preaching each night, Monday through Wednesday night, 7:30. And so we'll pray for their meeting coming up, it'll start Sunday, but go through Wednesday night. So pray for the meeting there. Amen. All right.